Are like, yeah, I'm grown. Get rid of God first. I was the Lord of my own throne. And searching for satisfaction is all that I know. Because before I became a man, I was just another middle class clone. When I became a man, I woke up. I stopped wasting my life hoping and wishing that a better life would just show up. I started listening to my mom, and for so long, since son, you need to grow up. So I grew up. And then the thought of an average life made me want to throw up. So I threw up. Yeah, I threw up my hands and said, God, I'm tired of being a boy. I'm ready to be a man. Because one day, when my son takes my hand, I want him to know that it's not about where his dad said, it's about where his dad stands.
Amen.
I want him to know that I believe in a God who inspires us to have big dreams. Bigger plans. I want to know that, son, if God is for you, the naysayers of this world will
stand. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Between being a boy and being a man.
Amen. Amen.
It's amazing to leave the boys to become a man. When I became a man, I did away with the notion of living for the weekend, because I looked at society and all I saw was weak men. Getting up on Monday, dying for Friday, traveling in these cars on the highways and byways like material things, all that defines me. At the cubicle jobs, trying to climb the ladder, claiming the money like it's all that matters. Boys who never became men, stuck forever in the past tense, trapped in spiritual adolescence.
Tell it. Tell it.
I became a man. I looked at my peers and said, I can. I'm gonna be like them, clinging to the latest trend, dying to fit in, judging each other by the cars that they're in. He's the man who drives the Benz. I became a man. I said, I want something more for my life. More than getting wasted under neon lights on Friday nights, only to wake up on Saturday morning with plans to do it again. There are too many boys in this world and not enough men.
Tell it.
I became a man. I said that when I leave this world, I want my life to have that purpose. So I stopped wasting my life on things that are worthless. Every minute on the couch in front of the TV was a wasted moment on a journey that should be defined.
Satan, get thee behind
us. I now believe that God desires for every father to courageously step up and do whatever it takes to be involved in the lives of his children. But more than just being there, providing for them. He's to walk with them through their young lives and be a visual representation of the character of God, their Father in heaven.
Amen.
The Father should love his children and seek to win their hearts.
Amen. Amen.
He should protect them,
amen,
discipline them, and teach them about God.
Yes.
He should model how to walk with integrity and treat others with respect. He should call out his children to become responsible men and women who live their lives for what matters in eternity.
Yes.
Some men will hear this and mock it, or ignore it. But I tell you that as a father, you are accountable to God for the position of influence.
Yes.
You can't fall asleep at the wheel, only to wake up one day and realize that your job or your hobbies have no eternal value, but the souls of your children do. Some men will hear this and agree with it, but have no resolve to live it out. Instead, they will live for themselves and waste the opportunity to leave a godly legacy for the next generation. But there are some men who, regardless of the mistakes we've made in the past,
tell it.
Regardless of what our fathers did not do for us, we'll give the strength of our arms and the rest of our days to loving God with all that we are, and to teach our children to do the same. And whenever possible, to love and mentor others who have no father in their lives, but who desperately need help and direction. We are inviting any man whose heart is willing and courageous to join us in this resolution. In my home, the decision has already been made. You don't have to ask who will guide my family, because by God's grace, I will. You don't have to ask who will teach my son to follow Christ, because I will. who will accept the responsibility of providing and protecting my family? I will. Who will ask God to break the chain of destructive patterns in my family's history? I will.
Yes.
Who will pray for and bless my children to boldly pursue whatever God calls them to do? I am their father. I am. I accept this responsibility, and it is my privilege to embrace it. I want the favor of God and His blessing on my home. Any good man does. So where are you, men of courage? Or are you fathers who fear the Lord?